There are many qualities and people make it very complicated. Oh, to become a big lawyer, you need to do this. No, it's very simple. Because once you master a thing, thing becomes simple. It's complex only before the mastery. So those who are struggling, those who are in the middle, consider things are very difficult. But once you have mastered, it's easy, it's simple. So seven C's, C with the capital word C, will start. So the first quality is C, means confidence. So write a checklist of being top lawyer. So first quality is confidence. Everything starts with confidence. Because if you do not have the confidence, how the clients will have confidence in you? How the judges who will listen, who will pass the judgment, will have confidence in you? So everything starts with self-confidence. Now, self-confidence does not mean arrogance. Self-confidence does not mean bragging. Self-confidence does not mean, I don't know in new movies, but in old movies there used to be this Rajkumar. Hum kisi ke samne kaam nahi karte. Now it's not confidence, it's bloody arrogance. Right? Confidence is, you are aware of your strength and you are aware of your limitation. And you are comfortable with your limitations. You know, what is the difference between a genius and a fool? Both will do foolish things, whether it's a genius or a fool. Genius is comfortable. Okay, I make mistake, what's a big deal? Fool will say, no, I never make mistake. Right? So a confident person does not have the difficulty in saying that I may be good in something, but I may not be good in other things. Right? Whereas a person who is arrogant will try to prove that he or she is good at everything. No. So first thing is confidence. Everything starts with that self-faith. That's the first quality. Second is, it does not come from the air that, oh, I am confident. Where does it come from? It should be grounded. And it is grounded in second quality, that is competence. Competence, ability to do something, ability to do things well. So competence. Because only when you are competent, you would be confident, otherwise it's an airy-fairy thing. So it is based on competence. How do you develop competence then, second quality? That comes from two things, and that's very important. First, say in the field of law, for example, you should have a clear understanding of basic concepts. Write down. Now one, basic concepts should be absolutely clear. Say for example, if say law, so what is law of contract, law of torts, crime, various constitution, administrative law principles, fundamental principles of interpretation. Fundamental concept should be very clear. So that is the conceptual part. So that's a conceptual foundation of law. At Harvard, at Oxford, what they teach you? They teach you how to be really strong in your conceptual understanding. That's what they teach. So now once you have a conceptual understanding, this is only conceptual. So without experience is not enough. Universities can give, good universities can give you good conceptual foundation. But law is a practical profession. So the real competence comes when you start doing things. So concept, understanding, then doing cases. Cases and cases and cases and cases. The more you do, the better you become. I started with G. Ramaswamy, Attorney General. I learned a lot from him. Then one day I asked famous lawyer, unfortunately no more, Arun Jaitley. So I asked Jaitley Saab, sir, how to be successful in practice? He said that the best way to learn is by doing it. And that was the best advice. The best way to learn is by doing it. So the more cases you will be doing, the more practical work you will be doing, the better you will be at it. But not just repeating, doing, taking risks, making mistakes, learning from them, right? But you have to take essentially the risk, courage to do things. You should not be just in the head, you have to put out in the real life, right? So competence comes from experience, conceptual understanding, which you will get in the university, and practical thing when you start practicing, right? So you have confidence, you have competence. Now, if you have both, but if you are not able to communicate to others, you may understand a thing, you have a good understanding, but then you should be able to communicate. So third quality, C, is communication, both in written and spoken English. Because English is the language most of the places, High Court or Supreme Court, only few places regional language will work, at trial court or whatever. But since law is an international subject, competence in English is very, very important. Though one should be proud of one's language and one should master both, right? Matri bhasha mein bhi utna hi adhipatya hona chahiye. You should have the mastery in your mother tongue also. I have noticed, in fact, one funny thing when I was studying at Harvard, one of my German friends said, Surat, one thing I don't understand. I said, what? When two Germans meet, they speak German. When two French meet, they speak French. When two Chinese meet, they speak Chinese. But when two Indians meet, they speak English. Don't you have any language of your own? I said, well, India is a vast country, so since there are so many languages, you know, and we are international people, so we speak English. But the thing is, you must have mastery over your mother tongue. Research shows that those who study their mother tongue first and foreign language afterwards, in long term, do better than those who study in a foreign language, right? So both mastery in your own language as well as English. So communication. Now, what is the communication? Communication means you should be able to convey your things to the another. Now, famous poet Ghalib said about communication, excellent. He said, apna kaha gar aap hi, samjhe to kya samjhe. Apna kaha gar aap hi, samjhe to kya samjhe. Maja kehne ka tab hai, ek kahe aur dusra samjhe. Maja kehne ka tab hai, ek kahe aur dusra samjhe. What does it mean in legal practice, whether it's civil litigation or criminal litigation? See, when you are drafting a thing, when you are drafting a petition, you are drafting an application, there is a target audience. It is not enough that you have a clarity in your head, oh, I have drafted very well. No, no. Whether the judge will understand or not, because it's the judge who has to pass the order. Right? Whether what you want to convey, you have ended up conveying to the other side. Right? So communication is, effective communication is, when the target audience understands it. Getting the point? So communication, that's third. Now, confidence is there, competence is there, then there is the communication. But supposing you don't get any client, so where will you show your competence? So for that purpose, which they do not teach you in law school, but very important, fourth category is connecting, social network or whatever way, making friends, right? So that when you start practice, there are people who can refer to you. So fourth thing is connecting, because it is only from connection you get the power, otherwise you are an isolated person, right? Many people talk about independence without understanding. Human beings are not independent, right? Human beings are connected, so it should be well connection. What is independence? A person in a jungle, forest is also independent, does not mean a thing, right? So the good quality is from dependence to independence, yes, but then from independence, next stage is also there, which is called interdependence, where you are connecting with the other person, you are independent, other person independent, but connecting, not like two rocks separate, right? So connecting, how should you connect? You should always connect on equal terms, right? If somebody is powerful, other is powerless, it's not connection, it's a domination or subordination. No, equal. The way, you know, when there's a famous saying, Alexander asked Porus that how you should be treated. And Porus said, the way a king treats another king, ek raja dusre raja ko jaise vyavhar karta hai. So you are all like lords or ladies, and you should connect with each other on equal terms. Right, that's connecting, that's a healthy connecting. because otherwise it's a power-driven society. So that's not healthy. So fourth thing is connecting. Right? Clear?